बिजनेस कंसल्टेंट हैदराबाद, श्री अनंत मोहन मिश्रा डेप्यूटी डीजीएफटी डीजीएफटी कोलकाता, एंड श्री कमल साहू टू भुवनेश्वर। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड एमर्जिंग। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट आर द इनिशिएटिव गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज टेकिंग टू कट द इम्पोर्ट एंड boost domestic manufacturing. A lot of initiative is being taken to reduce the import dependency. Government of India, Ministry of Commerce identified 12 key sectors. The detailed sector-wise presentation will be presented by S.N. Panigrahi. And also we have received about 66 products identified by Ministry of MSME that MSME can take up. Can produce that domestically, and we are highly dependent on China, USA, United Arab, Saudi Arab, Iraq, Hong Kong, and the top importing products are petroleum products, gold, natural gas, coal, diamond, aluminium, crude oil. So the detailed discussion will be continued. So I am requesting Dr. S.K. Sao, Director in Charge MSMDI Cuttack, to give a view on the student. The webinar. Yes, sir.
So, thank you, Nayak Babu. On behalf of MS, is it audible?
Yes, audible to all.
So, on behalf of MSME Development Institute, Government of India, Cuttack, I convey my sincere thanks on behalf of the Institute to Sri S.N. Panigrahi, Business Consultant, Hyderabad, Mr. Anand Mohan Mishra, Deputy DGFT, DGFT of Kolkata, Sri Kamalkant Sahu, Odisha Chapter PO of this Bhubaneswar, and the this webinar program coordinator, Dr. S.N. Naik, Assistant Director of this Institute. In fact, this topic, export substitution strategy advantages for MSMEs, it has been decided
sir,
and mandate from the...
Sir, what's your name? PPT, sir.
PDF, sir.
requesting all participants to mute your audio, please. All participants, please mute your audio.
Sir, how is the setting also without, sir? Sir, upon out here, in front of हाँ ना सर सिस्को टिके माने ये रहू सर टिके बहुत तर हमने सेटिंग अपन सर थोड़े एग्जिस्टेड ना बाहर जाऊँ सर
कंटिन्यू
सर। सो ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु आर प्रेजेंटिंग इन दिस वेबिनार आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट दैट दे शुड म्यूट एंड व्हेनेवर दे आर इंटरेस्टेड टू आस्क something after the presentation by the guest speakers, and they may do so, and meanwhile they may mute so that other people will not be having some problem. So this import substitution strategy for MSMEs, we have arranged on behalf of the Government of India, Ministry of MSME, and as per the direction of Development Commissioner's Office, Government of India. You might be knowing all that those who are working in this MSME sector. This sector is a very crucial to the growth and the development of the Indian economy, considering the contribution 32% to the gross value added, and employing around 111 million people in the entire economy. And they are also the major contributor for manufacturing output. They provide 45%, and to the export sector, it is 48%. They are contributing in the total export sector from the India. The main problem is that then after this COVID-19, as per the win-win situation, trade war between China and America. Government of India is also interested to do some intervention, particularly medical and auxiliary activities, so that that can be having the more penetration in the international market, which is having a competitive strength. And now this is the right time. Since the India India and China, they are having some border issues, and now the market is open, and China is having in the world market some problem. Many countries are also offering the platform to the India that they can produce something, they can have a big opportunity, and they can grab the possibility, and they can enter into their market and to sell their products also. And this is the right time, so to say, since we are having more resources, more human resources, more natural resources, we are having that much of a capability, technologically sound, innovation is there. So everything is very conducive. And this conducive, this COVID period, we will think more so that in what best we can, having the intention or the main objectives, having the more export and less import. And what are those items, particularly in the entire country, we have to identify. And specifically in the state of Odisha, this is my submission that whatever the items, recently 12 key sectors, 12 key products have been identified by the Government of India and the Commerce Minister, Mr. Piyush Goyal, has declared, and they have considered these are the vital products which can be or export potential. And these items are the priority sector items are food processing, organic farming, iron and steel, aluminium and copper, agrochemicals, electronics, industrial machinery, furniture, leather and footwear, auto parts, textile and marine products. So these are the potential products that they have identified. In addition to this, Ministry of MSME, Office of the Development Commissioner has circulated a list of 66 items at the 8-digit level, 8-digit HS level, and considering we have examined that in the state of Odisha, we are having the potentiality or some competitive advantage in the case of 17 products. Before this, Mr. Dr. Nayak was telling to all of you, and these 17 items are static converter, electric lamps and light fitting, fixed electrical capacitor, parts of electrical transformers and inductors, all these things are there. Considering the nature of constraints, need of capacity building and policy issues for these products, we have identified, and more analysis and more identification of the products, particularly for export promotion and import substitution, we will hear from the export faculty, Mr. Panigrahi. And at the same time, what are the products that are penetrating in our market? What is our role? What is our policy? How will play the check and balances? And this will help us for the domestic exporters. They can go ahead of such manufacturing of such products or such providing or rendering services of such products, so that the market size or the economy of the Indian market, that will be having a boost for the Indian MSME exporters. So with these few words, I am here, and thanks for the panelists and the participants who are present here, particularly our earlier friend Hakim Babu is here, I have seen. So thank you very much, and also our member, he is here. So thank you very much. Now here the analysis or the import substitution items from our panel speakers, panel experts. And it is my submission that if the presentation is not visible, then without wasting time, then we can also go ahead with the audio system, because audio having no problem and all are having the audio tracking and they are listening. So thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable comments. So participants are slowly joining. We have around 60 participants. I request all participants to mute your audio, please. On on behalf of I invite Sri S. N. Panigrahi, corporate trainer and business manager. Audio, please, Trilochan Kora, please mute your audio. Trilochan Kora, so I request Sri S. N. Panigrahi to start his presentation.
Thanks, Mr. Naik, and I thank to Dr. S. K. Sahuji and all the panelists. This is a brief my profile. I am an international corporate trainer, mentor and author, having almost like 30 years of experience and made presentations of more than 150 workshops globally I have conducted, and also more than 500 articles I published, and more than 90 YouTube presentations and 90 plus slideshare presentations also available for the public domain. This is just my brief profile. Later also you can contact, my contact details also available. So let us go to the subject instead of matchmaking. Let us go to the subject. The subject is that import substitution. In fact, import substitution is a very years old economic concept to protect the Indian, domestic market or domestic industry. So this is the next slide. So it is a very old concept, and to protect the domestic production and industry. And in fact, in 1950s and 1960s, this was mostly popularized. Then after, of course, after the globalization concepts have come, then free trade concepts have come, this is evaded, and then it is for gone case. But again, it has been reviving because of the present scenario, because a lot of supply chain disruptions has happened because of corona, this virus, and various other border tensions and other related political tensions. So now again the concept is coming up. People are talking about the globalization, but localized globalization, and therefore they are coming back to again import substitution to some extent. So next slide. So import substitution, just I will go to the subject directly. I will not talk about much of the economic theory part. Directly I will go to the subject. So the import substitution, from the two points I want to discuss. One is from the, because we have a huge domestic consumption is there, that is a very large market, that is a potential for the growth for the economy. So from that point I will discuss about the discouraging the non-essential import, how that non-essential imports can boost domestic production, and as a result our economy will improve. The second aspect I talk about, because the import substitution also is required, because most of the times we are encouraging import for the export production, but that we had to rethink, because our export promotion policies are mostly import oriented, but we has to now revamp the foreign trade policy to encourage the local content in the export. So that is the two aspects I want to focus on this presentation. One is for discouraging the non-essential imports, that is the first we want to discuss here. And India is importing almost like 11,500 types of various products, mainly the crude oil, and followed by this gold and electronic goods. Also in the recent past, it is a substantial imports are being done for the gold and electronic goods especially. So this is worrisome, because certain things are very essential like crude oil, but certain other things which are non-essential items also emerging, and it is actually creating a lot of economic disturbance in terms of balance of payment. And traditionally India became a negative balance of payment, or this adverse balance of payment, because imports are more, and exports are less. As a result, on our foreign exchange reserves, it is putting certain pressure on it. And the present situation even worsened because of the coronavirus, because a lot of domestic economic activities also been reduced. And the other hand, the exports also reduced. So it may create in the future lot of trouble. Of course, at present we have good reserves of foreign exchange, but it can create certain trouble in the future. So India is, of course, some time back identified those non-essential items. In fact, this exercise is started almost like 2 years back. In 2018, that exercise is rigorously started, but actions are not visible much, but a lot of back-end exercise, back-end preparations are being done, and they have identified, as Dr. S.K. Sahuji talking about, Government of India has identified 12 major sectors where the imports can be reduced and domestic production can be encouraged. And some of the non-essential items, like I will tell you, like toys, for example, recently in Mann Ki Baat, our Prime Minister also have a mention about the toys, which are non-essential, and also certain times it is creating hazards for the children. And plastic items, sports items, furnitures, and household steel items, electronic goods, electrical items, wristwatches, wall clocks, and many of the glass items, and even shampoo and face treatments also, hair creams, all those things also now coming as an import, which is creating, of course, a greater pressure on Indian economy. As a result, our MSME sector mainly has been affected. Next, Naik Bob. So, mainly our worry is from the China. In fact, China, this import from China is gradually increasing, and in recent past, of course, it is a very tremendous increase. So it is creating certain dependency on China. What are the dependencies? That items also I'll show you. But some of the sectors, and for example, pharmaceutical sector, for the API, they're mostly means raw material. Most of them, they are depending on China, which is creating certain trouble, and also we have some tensions with China in the border. Therefore, it may create certain pressure on Indian economy. So, from China, we are importing almost like 14% of the total imports, and non-essential imports from China is amounting to 4 trillion a year. 4 trillion means 4 lakh crores. That is a huge amount we are importing from India, from China. And also there is a trade deficit, because we are importing more from China and very less we are exporting to China. As a result, there is a trade deficit is there. The trade deficit with China is at present is 48.66 billion in 2019-20. But in the previous year, it was much higher. Of course, it is reduced, but still that gap is there, very huge gap is there. That is worrisome. And the trade deficit between, what are the major imports you see? These are the major imports we are making from China. Mainly this is the nuclear and reactors, boilers parts, automobile spares, and fertilizers. And coming like that, if the API you see, it's almost like 68% means of pharmaceutical raw materials we are depending on China, and also basic chemicals and electrical and electronic goods, almost 60% we are depending on China that imports. So this is what the real worrisome for India. And as a result of the recent the trade related worries are there, because in the border we have the tensions. So if China is stopped the import exporting to India, or we are stopping, what are the consequences? That is also very grave, because we are not immediately like prepared. Like APIs, for example, pharmaceutical raw materials, over a period we are mostly depending on China. So that is very worrisome for our pharmaceutical industry. If we stop immediately, what could be the impact? So let us, of course, make some initiation, and of course some drastic steps we have to take for non-essential items. We have to stop it. Government also taken time to time many measures. Some of the measures we'll discuss in subsequent slides. Next. So from the trade barriers from the WTO compatible trade barriers I'll talk. One is about the tariff related barriers. Another is non-tariff barriers. Tariff related barriers means like customs duty or various other forms of taxation, levy of the taxes. Therefore, the trade can be controlled or restricted. That is one aspect. The other one is non-tariff barriers. Now, in the next slides, I will show you what are those trade related tariff barriers we have made. That is also I will tell you. And whether it is effective or not also we discuss. And starting from the 2014, of course, we have increased gradually on lot of the items, the tariffs, means customs duty, to the extent of almost like 3,600 tariff items, we have increased the customs duty. And also we have taken many measures to increase the customs duty in the recent time. Also there is a discussion at present to increase the customs duty to 20 to 25% on pharmaceutical ingredients. So that is also we are discussing about. So many of the items in the future, last few months if you say, and drastically we have taken a decision about, for example, on furnitures, on toys and air conditioners, and also on various other items, electronic items, the rate of customs duty is increased. Next slide. But even though increased, that effect is not very, proven effect. It is not reduced the Chinese import, from China imports are not reduced. But still that imports are there, even despite the increase of the customs duty, that effect is not clearly visible. One of the reasons are, of course, we are also, everybody is involved in this trade, or some way or other way is responsible, because we are preferring Chinese items. And Chinese traders also, what is happening is, they are making the under-invoicing. As a result, for example, a mobile is there, that rate of the MRP is, for example, in the market, it is a 30,000, but suppose they declare a 10,000, and on that, even though increased duty has been paid, that is not making much effect. So therefore, they are continuing with imports with under-invoicing or wrong declarations. All these things are still continuing. So government is now thinking of going for the non-tariff measures, which may be effectively control the imports. So next slide. So we are now going for the non-tariff measures. And what are those non-tariff measures also we'll discuss. And one of them is the technical regulations and many other non-tariff barriers. Now government is proposing to implement it. Already they have identified 371 products where they want to put stringent technical norms or quality related norms so as to reduce the imports. And already they have formulated for 150 products and that worth of almost like 47 billion of worth of imports. For that they have already formulated certain types of quality norms. And over 50 quality control orders are being issued, and further it is going on. Next slide. So this is where one of the managing the controlling the imports, and India is set to finalize the stricter quality standard. That is what 371 items, and this categorization is 111 items from the chemical and petrochemical sector, and 68 items from the heavy industries, and 62 items from the electronics and information technologies, and 61 items from the industry department, and 44 items from the steel ministry, and 25 items from the telecom department. So these are these 371 items total they have identified. On that, some of the actions already they are making it. Next slide. So next slide. So this BIS, Bureau of next no no sorry sir back back yeah the BIS no no now forward forward yeah here here so BIS quality standards, of course we have already existing some 25,000 quality standards are there, but only 150 quality standards are mandatory, but others are all voluntary basis. Now we are going for more stricter norms for the import, And of course, when they are making import, that equalization mechanism has to make so that it is equally applicable to domestic suppliers also, or domestic industry also. Because we had to make the equalization both for the import and domestic players. So that the exercise is going on. Next slide. Yeah. And also we have a formulated a policy from the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. And this is called this Electronics and Information Technology Goods Requirement for Compulsory Registration, that is CRS, they call it, Compulsory Registration Scheme. This was in fact introduced in 2012, but in recent time this is make more stringent, so that most of the electronic items which we are importing from various other countries, especially from China, and there are certain norms are now prescribed. As per this, no person shall manufacture or store for sale or import, sell or distribute goods which do not conform to the Indian standard specifications as specified in the order. So as per those specifications, they identified the electronic items. And further, because one of the worrisome for India, as I told you, after the crude oil and gold, next is the electronic items. That is most prominently in the recent past, is very fast growing. And that is also putting pressure on our balance of payment situation. Our trade deficit is also increasing because of these reasons. So that is how we want to control these imports. Next slide. And recently, one more observation also made that some of the FTA provisions are being misused by various means, wrong declarations or wrong routing. Or for example, the paper has coming from the Vietnam, but it is declared as origin from the Sri Lanka and coming to India. And India and Sri Lanka has the Sri Lanka trade, India-Sri Lanka trade agreement. So they are enjoying the zero rate on that paper. Otherwise, it's supposed to be very high, almost like 60% tax supposed to be, custom duty supposed to be paid, but they are enjoying the zero rate customs duty because of the misuse of this type of provisions. Next slide. Some of the examples also I'll show you what are those FTAs are there, and through that, what are the misuse been done. Next. These are the notifications they issued recently in the August only, effective from the effective from the 21st of September. And this is the rules of origin that regulations are made through those notifications. Next slide. And because of these restrictions, means FTA misuse can be stopped. That is one of the regulating import from the other countries, mainly from China, but routing through some FTA, our country, means partner countries. So that is one of the reason for this rule of origin they implemented recently from this year. And next, the other one is DGFT also from that site. They are also putting most of the items from the free to restricted. Means earlier it has been allowed free of freely without any license or without any approvals from the concerned authority, freely we can import, but those are been put into the restricted items. Some of them I will show in the next slide. This is as per the provision of the foreign trade policy under section schedule 1 of the ITC HS. The provisions are there for import. They can put imports can be freely importable, or it is restricted, or it can channelized, or it's prohibited. So accordingly, we can shift that mechanism as per the WTO norms only. So DGFT, recently they put some electronic items for colored televisions, for example, from the July 31st, 2020 onwards, very recent provision. They put these into the restricted category. Earlier it was free to import, but a lot of misuse has been done, and huge imports have been done from the China and various other countries like Vietnam, Malaysia and Hong Kong, Korea, Indonesia, Thailand and Germany, like many of the countries it's coming, but prominently it is from China and from other countries again through China routing. Means Chinese material, but other countries it is entering, and from there it is entering to India. So therefore they made this one of the condition Now it is not freely importable, but it is restricted for import. The second item is pneumatic tires. That is from the 12th of June 2020. These items are put into the restricted category. Earlier it is free to import, but is now put into the restricted category. And India is importing huge amount of the tires, despite we have the capacity to manufacture, in fact. And this is almost like $370 million worth is mostly coming from China and other Thailand and other countries. Similarly, on the 8th of June, January 2020, palm oil also, refined palm oil. Of course, we have a very huge capacity of the refining the palm oil, but refined palm oil is coming from Malaysia and other countries. And through FTA also, these materials are coming through Nepal, enjoying the zero rate facility. Because Malaysia, if you come, it is almost like 40% or so the import duty is there. But when it's coming from Nepal, we have a Nepal-India treaty is there. So that they can enjoy the zero rate custom duty, the imports is possible. So like that, they are routing it, so misusing the FTA provisions. Therefore, Government of India has taken a policy decision to restrict it through restricted items, so that there is a requirement of the license from the DGFT. Similarly, if you see the import of the toys, the increase of the rate of the duty is also made, but mostly these are 80-85% of the toys are coming worth of almost like 4,000 crores from mostly from China. And therefore, the government has recently taken a decision to put these items through the control order, quality control order of the BIS, so that there is some restrictions can happen. And also silk imports, of course, recently that provision is there taken for imposing the anti-dumping duty from the imports from the China is made, so that it is restricted. But otherwise, huge imports have been coming of the silk imports, despite we have the capacity to do that silk domestically. And also recent case of viscous staple fiber. And of course, it is only one company is there, of course, so that is Aditya Birla Group. But they are mostly affected because the Chinese import China and Indonesia and Thailand, huge imports have been coming, so that the anti-dumping measures have been taken to restrict these imports. So like that, Government of India is taking in recent times, one is tariff related and it is non-tariff related also measures are being taken. Next slide. Yes. Another example of this one is solar panels, because at one time we don't have much of the capacity to manufacture the solar panels, but over a period India also started manufacturing the solar panels. And in 2018 July, India has imposed 25% safeguard duty, because a huge surge of the imports happening from the China. Therefore, they imposed the 25% safeguard duty, and that expiring in July again 2020. Therefore, they again reimposed that rate of the duty has now increased, and that rate of duty is imposed now is 20-25% of the basic custom duty they imposed. Therefore, it can restrict the or control the solar panels import, mostly from the China. Therefore, once we restrict the import, then there will be gap, because demand is anyhow is there. Therefore, they create a gap. That gap can be filled by the domestic players, domestic manufacturers. And we continue to encourage the import, never our domestic market can flourish. They can't compete with cheap imports. That imports, one of the reason why that are cheap is, especially from China, not only Chinese competitiveness, but government supported many schemes they are enjoying, and government backed support is there, whereas our domestic players are not equally placed at along with these Chinese importers, Chinese suppliers. So that is why certain times of protection is required. That is why through import duty increase that protection is provided. Next. next night. Yeah. So, of course, recent times some of the Chinese imports of the solar panels have come down, but still there is a further scope is there, so that then only Indian manufacturers can come out. That is what the substitution we are talking about, the main topic. The substitution can happen because there is an unequal parity is there between the importers and the domestic players. So unless we control the imports, we can't be the domestic players can't be competitive and they can't flourish. That is what the most of the domestic players over a period, for example, in pharmaceutical APIs, they are falling down. Once upon a time, we have the good capacity to manufacture raw materials for the, that is the API that has been called. Those are being manufactured in India, but over a time, we are slowly giving up and that imports are dominant and domestic players are vanished. Now again, because of the problems, now again it is creating, but it takes a lot of time. And of course, a lot of criticism also there. Many of the countries are talking about mainly when these hydraulic tires have been restricted, then a lot of criticism come that we are going to the license laws. Means again, like the previous some decades back, that's economic situation was there, like every item we require the license. Similar, like we are going back to the license laws. For that, Piyush Goyal, in one of these FICCI meeting, FICCI organized one of the meeting, he has clarified it is not going back to the license rights, but it is in fact protecting the domestic industry. It is a fair playing. It is not like like domestic play, but it is fair playing. And many other countries also doing. For example, our Indian products, if it's going to the Europe, especially if you see the agriculture items, lot of restrictions are there. Lot of times they're imposing various types of parameters and they're rejecting on that basis. Because that is within that purview, as per the WTO norm, the technical parameters can be made, technical standards can be made, that can be changed from time to time. And they are taking that advantage and rejecting our Indian products. So similar like our Piyush Goyal also told, why not we also can do it? Yes, he has justified talking about like that, because we have a 1.3 billion Indians are there. That is a huge market, huge business opportunities there. If they want to come to India, let them follow our technical norms also, which we are very liberal earlier, but now we want to put those restrictions. Next. And also he has invited to this trade business people from abroad, come to India and invest it. And India lists that 38 drugs, raw materials, which India at present, as I told you already, we are importing mostly, we are dependent, almost 68% to 70% we are depending on only from China. Now, of course, government has identified 38 such drugs which we can manufacture in India. Those APIs we can manufacture in India. So that is a good step forward taken. And in fact, if you see last 1 year, there is some reduction also happened about this import from the China. And further that can happen if we are rigorously follow the policy of indigenization for the supporting the our own industry. And also our exports can be flourished once our industry raw material backing also, backward integration also happens, then we will be more strong in our exports also. So therefore, government has identified this is one of the key area, and very huge potential is there. India has a huge capacity for this pharmaceuticals. So that is what they're taking measures for 38 items to identified for the manufacturing within India. And also edible oils. Edible oils, if we see, traditionally we are importers. Our total need is like 25,000 million tons edible oil requirement per annum. And of course, almost like 50-60% we are importing, including the palm oil, including various types of oils are there, like coconut oil, rice bran, or cotton seed oils, or many sunflower oil, and many things, groundnut oil, mustard oil, rapeseed oil, like many oils we are importing. And why not we create our own? because it is a huge demand is there, that demand is further increasing only, never it comes down because of the population and its consumption. And if you make the policy provisions for creating this, means it is agriculture based, so if you make the seeds also produced within India, then it is a huge opportunity for India. Huge opportunity. One side the agriculture will grow and supporting to it, industry also can grow and lot of foreign exchange can be saved, and that is a real substitution, import substitution. So this is very good opportunity is there. India can tap it because almost 60% we are importing only. A huge opportunity. Next. Next. This export-led, our import policy is some flaws are there. One side I talked about import substitution or restricting the imports, but other side we are not equally treating our domestic industry at par with the imports. One of the things, I have an example I take because of short of time I will not deliberate much, but let us take the key point, that deemed exports we call it. Deemed exports is very good thought, very good alternative for imports. Means domestic, the exporters for the raw material, packing material, consumables, etc., they can source from the domestic market instead of import. So this is conceptually very nice, a very good policy. But if you see the policy provisions, it is not equalized, means it is not deemed exports are not equally treated with imports. And deemed exports is that the definition is that the goods supplied do not leave India and payments may be in Indian rupees or foreign currency, and such items must be manufactured within India. So with these three parameters, this is the definition of deemed exports. But if you go to the next slide, if you go to the deemed export as per this foreign trade policy and as per this GST, both are entirely different. The definitions are different. GST, they are confined very few items, mainly four categories only, they called as in deemed exports. One is the goods supplied to this advance authorization holders, or goods supplied to EPCG license holder, or goods supplied to EOU units, or in the gold also, when the banks are exchanging, that is also treated as deemed exports. But only these four categories are treated as deemed exports, whereas in foreign trade policy, deemed export definition is very wide. And suppose you are an international bidding, you are one, and you are supplying to the contractor who have won the international bidding, or they are supplying to the nuclear power plants, like that, if they are super thermal power plants, ultra super power thermal plants, then also these are treated as deemed exports. But as per the customs and GST notifications, these are not treated as deemed exports. Means we are not making the equal treatment for that. And procedures wise also, deemed exports are very complicated, and there is virtually there is no benefits are assigned to these domestic suppliers, because domestic supplier, in case of GST I am talking about, they have to pay first the GST, then they have to get for the refund after 3-4 months or even more. But whereas that import, you can import in advance almost like 180 days before you can import, because that import export obligation is given this 18 months. So 18 months before you can import and enjoy the duty-free materials, and many people are misusing also. They import duty-free, duty-free including the customs duty and all other duties, including this anti-dumping duty and anti-subsidy duty and etc. If anything is there, they are importing. And importing, and then obligation is in 18 months. Whereas if we go to the this deemed export provisions, if you procure from the domestic market, then you have to pay first the GST, and then you have to claim the refund after say 3-4 months. So that is very not equal treatment, and it is a stepmotherly treatment for the domestic players. That is what imports are encouraged. Therefore, I call always, those are not export promotion schemes, but those are import promotion schemes. We are encouraging importing only, but not equal treatment or equal facilities are provided for the domestic suppliers in the name of deemed exports. So therefore, we are losing lot of foreign exchange, and in the name of export promotion, we are really import promotion and encouraging the our foreign suppliers. That incentives are going to the our foreign suppliers, not to the domestic players. So that is what we have to look into, revise our foreign trade policy. Right? Then I will come, because time is short, I am going closer to that. This is government incentives, what they are taken. And recently, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called for, I call it the nation's call, and he called for this during the crisis period, call for the nation to be self-reliant. The self-reliant, this entire Bharat Abhiyan Yojana is entirely on the self-reliance, means it is a localization. Means always he is in his speeches, he is talking about vocal to the locals. And recent in Mann Ki Baat, when he is talking about the children, he is interacting and addressing to children. And there also he talks about the toys. Why we import the toys? Why not our own indigenous toys can be played? So that is what he is always talking about, local, focal to the local. And he's called these five pillars of the self-reliance. Self-reliance means that is again, means import substitution is one of the part of the self-reliance. And we should not depend on the foreign suppliers, but we have to have our own backward integration so that we can support to the, our industry, our exports, right? And here he is talking about the five pillars, that economy, infrastructure and systems, democracy and demand. So all these five parameters has taken. Based on that, again, on the foundation, we have a land and we have a labor and we have a laws and we have a local complete good talent is there. That is what he has recognized. We have good talent. We have facilities are there. Resources are there. And that is what he called for the self-reliance campaign is running every month after month, every time one Mann Ki Baat and wherever he meets. And he is talking about the vocal, about the local. So that is where we have to take the inspiration and move forward. And the government has taken certain measures, in fact, from the government side. One is for the import ban on the telecommunication items. Most of the BSNL or MTNL and other telecom communication players are mostly importing and depending on that. So he has called for to ban those imports. Also, he has called a banning for the power equipments which are we importing, almost at 71,000 crores of the power equipments we are importing, mostly from the China again. So he has called for this to ban it, because through government agencies is trying to put lot of a ban so that that gap, what is the demand gap is there, that can be fulfilled through import substitution, means domestic players. So also he has made it the defense sector, in fact, which is a very prominent, very strong sector where we are mostly depending on imports. Now we are called about self-reliance on this defense. So 101 items they banned for the import, and now they are procuring from the domestic only. And also some contracts they are going to release. In recent example is for 2580 crores of the deals for the rocket launchers they made to the Bharat Earth Movers and Tata Power and L&T, they awarded already. So like that, they are giving this focus on the domestic procurement only. Major is one of the is a domestic this defense sector, right? And also certain other governments also now they are cancelling the Chinese projects. One is from the Maharashtra government, they have cancelled that bid for 5,000 crores of this. Uddhav Thackeray government has cancelled that Chinese project. And also other governments like UP government and many other governments also come forward to ban the Chinese projects. Because Chinese are very strongly entered into infrastructure industry also. So that unless we stop them, our industry can't prosper. We can't compete with them, because there is always from the Chinese supply, there is backing from the China. And many other factors also there. Therefore, we can't compete with the undue practices where they do it, which India, our manufacturers can't do it. And my message is, unless we have the strong domestic manufacturing base, and we can't be very competitive in exports also. So, import substitution is very much essential to strengthen our means manufacturing base, and because of the scale and scope, we can expand and we can do lot of exports also. Next, and of course, Dr. S.K. Sahuji has already talked about. We have identified, the government has identified 12 sectors, and those 12 sectors mainly from the food processing, organic farming, iron, aluminium and copper, agrochemicals, electronics, industry, machineries, furnitures, like many other items, like 12 sectors, they have identified certain items, and those we can manufacture within domestic market. Domestically we can manufacture it, and therefore this next steps are, they're taking lot of steps already on the furnitures, they have taken on the toys, they have taken the steps to restrict the imports so that that gap can be filled by the domestic players. That is what the import substitution can happen, right? And industry bodies, that is the voice of industry also I'm talking about, that industry body, one of them is the Federation of Indian Micro and Small and Medium Enterprises, FISME. They have called, they have identified some 600 items, and they want to ban those items for import. They want to stop those import items. That is what they have identified. And next, another industry body, that is Confederation of All India Traders, and they are representing almost 7 crore traders and 40,000 trade associations are there. They have announced and want to, there's the announcement, it's a call actually, 3,000 Chinese products they have identified to ban it. And also some of the industries, for example, JSW, their director, Mr. Parth Jindal, managing director of the JSW Cement, they have also come forward that net import of, say, $400 million from the China per annum, they want to cut out. In next 24 months, they want to stop to it zero. Means complete, they want to procure from the domestic market instead of Chinese import. So that is one. And also Hero Cycles also announced that for 900 crores worth of investments, they want to cancel it. That is what they want to go for the Chinese investment. They want to cancel it. So like that, industry also coming forward, and industry bodies also coming forward. There is strong, next year, there is strong anti-China sentiment is developing because of the various tensions we have for this China. And that is how our ability also, if you see, within a short period of time, earlier we don't have any manufacturing facility for PPEs, but we become the world's second largest manufacturer. And further, there is a lot of opportunities also there to manufacture it. This is very good scope. That is, the gap is there. We can fill up the gap. We can go about. And also, though we are talking about, there is a lot of demand is there. For example, the Corona kits. And those are still we are importing from China. And we had to fasten our production so that we can stop those procurement from China. Next slide. And of course, as I told you, there is a strong sentiment of the anti-China sentiment domestically and outside India also. Because of the domestic, because of the 12 our soldiers are being killed, then after there is a strong voice is raised against China. That sentiment is going on. And outside India also, US, Australia, New Zealand, Canada and the EU countries also raising the voice. So that opportunity we can take it. Of course, crisis forcing us to re-examine and innovate and convert this crisis into opportunity. And next, of course, India has to innovate. How this Chinese is prospering despite worldwide there is a economic fall down, and only the country China, next slide you can see, only one country, that is China, they have prospered. All other countries has a negative growth, you can see from this table. All other countries are negative growth, and India is very very strongly very negative growth only. That's 24% contraction happened in the economy, GDP. But on the other hand, China has improved 3.2%. That is a positive growth happened. All other countries had negative growth, but the only country China is negative growth because certain innovations they are taking, very fast decisions they are taking, that they are taking the advantage of it. But why not we also? Why not we also innovate? And recent, if you see the publication, we become the world's top 50 countries globally innovating index. We have come the 50th country. right? Means 48th country, means below 50 countries we have come in. But our innovations are still lagging, and why not we innovate a lot? So that is an opportunity there. How the Chinese toys are very attractive, just to keep it, I will talk a little bit and close it. How the Chinese companies are prospering and why we are not able to prosper it. Why the Chinese toys are most attractive, why not Indian toys are attractive? Because Chinese are innovating. Not only their products are cheap, but those are very attractive, very innovative, something new. Not like old our traditional wooden toys. They have innovated a lot. So we also have to innovate. That is an opportunity. And finally, as an Indian, every person has its own nationality concerns. When our soldiers are fighting in the border, and they are every day they have a fight, and there are many deaths also happening. Still, why we not, as a citizen of India, boycott the Chinese products? Then only real substitution of import substitution can happen. Because as long as we are going with the Chinese product, we can't help it. No government can help. Government is making certain measures, but from everybody, every Indian citizen has a responsibility, has to come out with his own national agenda, like, so boycott the, which are possible, non-essential items. Okay, there is a mobile, which equal mobile is not available in India of that quality or that technology. Okay, I'm not talking about it. But why we import that the mobile pouches also, mobile covers also we import. Why we can't manufacture within India? When we stop it, then that can be taken by some manufacturer in India. Therefore, that is the real substitution. So every Indian has to contribute for it. Similar, like, why the dragon kites flies in our Indian skies? Can't we make the patang in India? The kites. Why we import? Earlier, in my earlier days, for example, 50 paisa, less than 50 paisa, we are purchasing a patang, that kites. And we are enjoying, not only enjoying, we are contributing to poor families. And those few poor families in the household only, they manufacture, that ladies and some children, they come together and they manufacture and they are selling and they are surviving. But now we are kicking on their stomach and dragging them to the road and asking to beg. And we are enjoying the Chinese dragon kites. Then where is the nationalism? Why we talk about the import substitution? When everybody is not participating, then only government can't help it. So which are possible, we can definitely do. Why we want India, Chinese kites? Similarly, why we want the Chinese made Indian gods and goddesses to pray? Like recently what happened in China, Chennai, lot of consignments have come from the China for the this Ganesh Murtis. Why we import from the Ganesh Murti from China? And when the custom department was delayed it, and there was a huge cry and huge cry across the trade, and trade unions also come forward and state bodies also come forward, and unnecessarily we are stopping the imports. Why Ganesh Puja, Ganesh idols are required from China? Can't we manufacture? Can't we manufacture agarbattis? Can't we manufacture diyas, which we put before the god? Why we import? And similarly, there are n number of things. Why we want to go for this import? Like as I told you, this is one of my observation, because everybody has to contribute. Then only this import substitution is faithfully, and it can be successful. Only because of the government, it's not be possible. And we have to come forward, and we have to give the hand and support to our Prime Minister's call for the vocal to the local. Then only the import substitution can be possible. Thanks a lot. Thanks for giving me this opportunity. Thanks to Dr. Nayak Sahab. Thanks to Dr. S.K. Sahuji and other panelists. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Panigrahi sir, for your nice presentation. I would like to request Sri Anand Misra, Deputy Director DGFT, to present his presentation. requesting Sri Mishra to give a brief
introduction. Hello.
Yes, you can present.
Okay. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. First of all, I would like to personally thank MSMEDI for involving me in this exercise, which is a very important topic as of today of import substitution. And I also would like to welcome and thank other panelists. Especially, I would like to thank SN Panigrahi ji, because he actually made my job a lot easy, because he gave a lot of examples and he also talked about basics of import substitution and what is happening. However, in my presentation, my approach would be little bit on a different approach, and here I would like all the exporter community to hear me out and think about their own product. I'm not going to talk in very general sense. Pick your product, whatever your product may be, whatever you are exporting, whatever you are manufacturing, just think about that product and just think. I am going to talk about each a few tools which can be used to reduce imports and increase exports. So I'm going to talk all those tools, and we are also going to discuss what are the limitations of those tools, so that you can actually do this exercise for your own industry, as a community or as an individual exporter, or with the help of MSMEDI or maybe MSME ministry, or with the help of your export promotion councils. You can come up with a strategy so that for your own sector, you can actually go for some of these tools to restrict imports and increase exports. So basically, I'm going to talk in much more practical terms what you can actually do. Second thing is that I would also like, while discussing these tools, I'm also going to talk about various challenges you have to see which a policymaker would face before he accepts your proposal, so that you are well aware about a policymaker's perspective also, so that when you are presenting your case to a policymaker, maybe MSME ministry, maybe Honorable Minister Nitin Gadkari ji, so you can present your case in a way so that you are aware what is going inside his mind, so that you can present your case accordingly. So in that sense, I'm going to talk about all these things. Recently, we all know that Atmanirbhar Bharat, vocal for local, or even Minister MSME, Mr. Nitin Gadkari ji, have said that government is thinking, and actually they have done a lot of things towards import substitution. So in this presentation, we are going to see those things. I think definition part is already taken care by the previous presenter, so I'm not going to do that. However, you have to understand few things, that this import substitution thing is not very new. Whenever there is economic crisis, whenever there is economic slowdown, whenever there is imbalance or breakdown in the distribution system, the countries would adopt protectionist approach and they would fall for import substitution. This is a fact. Every country does it. When it comes to their own survival, they come to import substitution. For example, in recent time, economic slowdown has resulted in America in form of Make America Great Again. So it is nothing but an import substitute, call for import substitution. Our call for Make in India, our call for Atmanirbhar Bharat, somewhere fits also in that situation. Recent time, as you might have noticed while presenting, the previous speaker talked about concern with China, concern of corona crisis, breakdown of a normal economic situation. And that's why the discussion on import substitution has come to the forum or to the forefront. So this is a reality. This is something which is not very new. Can I request others to kindly mute it, because it's creating a little bit of problem.
Please mute your audio, please. Please mute your audio.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So, for example, try to understand, at one point in time when we got independence till 1990, we had actually import substitution strategy. There was something flawed with it. There were some issues because of which it didn't work. And finally, we have to open our economy. So while going for import substitution, we have to understand one thing, that we cannot do the mistakes or commit the mistakes which we were making before 1990 era. So as previous presenter mentioned, we cannot go for license raj. That was one of the limitations of the old import substitution period. So just keep that in mind, that we have to learn from our old import substitution to come up with an import substitution which is compatible with the modern situation and does not carry the problems of old import substitution. That's why I'm going to talk about positives of each tool and also the negatives and the limitations of those tools. So if you think from policymakers or from my perspective, then I have to not only think about you, I have to think about various stakeholders. For example, for me, the domestic industry, which is manufacturing the product, which wants to act on import substitution, it is the primary stakeholder. But apart from it, I also have to think about consumers. When I say I have to think about consumers, you have to keep in mind that consumers can be divided in two types. One good could be finished product, where the consumer is any person who is consuming that good. Other could be an industry itself. An industry itself could be procuring intermediate goods, which it will finish up and then sell that product abroad again or export it. For example, a lot of things are not. For example, take the case of pharmaceutical. APIs, right now we are mostly dependent on China. So suddenly if you stop import of chemicals or the APIs, your own pharma industry will collapse. Try to understand this. So, as me as a consumer of a mobile phone is totally different from pharma industry as a consumer of an intermediate product, which it is importing solely for the purpose of production of something else. Okay? So, while I will take a decision, I might be taking more aggressive import substitution strategy for finished mobile product, or maybe Ganesh ji, or maybe mobile cover. But I would be mindful of import substitution while talking about APIs. Because first, I need to make sure that my downstream consumer, which is a pharmaceutical industry, have the raw material within this domestic industry so that I do not hamper their business. So I'm just giving you a policy maker's perspective that whatever your product is, you have to understand whether your product is intermediate goods, whether your product is finished good. If you are making a finished good, government is more likely to agree to your request. But if you are making an intermediate good, then government will take due diligence whether enough domestic availability of that product is not there or not. Okay? So just try to differentiate these things. Apart from it, we cannot make a decision solely based on whims. There are international rules. For example, WTO, we are a member of WTO, we often talk about WTO, and we need to comply with its regulation also. So it's not that if you want to stop imports, you can raise tariff to any level. You can do anything, whatever you want to do. For imposing an anti-dumping duty, you need to take a proper due diligence, you need to conduct investigation, right? Only after that you can impose anti-dumping duty. So, because we are a member of WTO, so government would be aware about those things also. So, it's not just that whatever we want to do, we can do. For example, electronics are being imported in a huge quantity. But if you see, we have agreed to IT agreement, right? Because of that agreement, a lot we cannot do at this stage. India wisely decided not to go for ITA 2. But because we are a member of ITA 1, hence a lot we cannot do. But you will see that government is somehow trying to raise tariff on mobiles and other products. Okay. Also, the third thing is we have to be cautious about foreign relations. We can freely talk about China right at the moment because we are having a souring relationship or not a good relationship with China. But same you cannot talk about US, right? Same you cannot talk about France because we are having good foreign relations. So foreign relations also play because suppose if a country's major export is API and imagine India had very good relationship with China, because of that compulsion, India could not stop API of pharma. So that will also matter. So whatever your product is, you have to find out which country is exporting that product to India. How are the relationships with India? If that relationship is very good, probably you will find that there is less support for your cause. But if the relationship, anything which we are importing from China, if you can prove that domestic availability is there, or it's an end product, government will be more forthcoming to support you. It's just trying to give you a perspective that how for your own product you should think about. I will just go to the next slide. Again, there are various measures taken recently by the government. I was asked to talk about some of them. I will not go into detail in reading these lines because there are various relief packages given during the COVID period by finance minister. You can go through them and you can obviously search them and you can know. So there is provisions for liquidity infusion. There is provision for easy credit availability and those things. Okay. Okay. Now why import substitution? I will also not go too much into detail, but I will try to highlight few points which you might have noticed in the previous presentation also. That one argument is infant industry argument, which is the main argument for import substitution given. That our industry is still developing. It is not able to compete with the foreign powers. Okay, foreign companies. We are not that competitive yet that we can compete with other countries and their products because they are doing a large economies of scale and they are highly competitive. But with this, there comes also a rider that how long you want to remain infant. So if you are going to argue based on this argument, that infant industry argument, that we are still developing, we are nurturing, we need protection, okay? Then you also should be ready that at the end, it cannot be perpetual. There has to have an end date set to it. So keep that in mind. Apart from it, a lot of trade balance we are trying to manage or we want to become self-independent also. So these are also reasons for import substitution. I don't want to get into it. I will probably spend more time on this slide because these are the tools which are used to curb imports. And now you have to start thinking which tool suits your industry better. One thing is raising tariff. Now try to understand what I'm going to say. In WTO, India has agreed to a bound rate that India will never impose a tariff beyond this rate. That rate, let's assume for a particular product, let's say textile, could be 40%. So India can never cross that 40% bound rate. But in reality, usually India operates at a lower tariff rate. That means India maximum can impose 40% tariff. But in reality, it only imposes 10% of the tariff. So there is still gap of 30%, which India can increase without violating WTO agreement. Why I'm saying this? For your product, try to find out what is the bound rate, what is the actual rate, what is the difference between bound rate and actual rate. And there you can pressurize government that you are not violating WTO. Why don't you try to increase little bit of tariff? So this is the way you should also think that for your product, find out what is the bound rate, find out what is the actual rate which is being imposed and try to persuade government that increase your duty. And that is what is being happened when previous presenter talked about that nearly 3,000 items, the tariffs have been increased. So they have not been increased violating WTO. They have been increased while complying with the WTO. So that scope might still be available for your industry, whichever industry you come from. You may come from some industries, try to find out what is the bound rate, what is the actual rate, find out the difference, and that is the gap where you can push government to increase the tariff. Second mechanism is anti-dumping duty and safeguard mechanism. These kind of mechanism requires investigation. These kind of measures requires much more rigorous exercise. But as an industry group, if you come around, if you make a presentation maybe to MSME minister, and if he puts a case for you, or maybe if your regional state MSME unit presents a case that we feel that this product is being dumped in our Odisha, then you can ask for anti-dumping duty. There will be some due diligence, and the outcome of it, there might be some duty imposed so that the dumping can stop. So this, but again, as I said, this requires much more coordinated, and probably you would be better to talk among yourselves, create a group and do this exercise, because this exercise is a little bit rigorous. You may approach MSME department, you may approach DGFT, my parent organization, you may approach export promotion councils to help you out in this regard. Now I will talk about some other measures. Quota. Recently, quota have been frequently used. However, quotas are in, I can't say on this forum, but simply they are not very comfortable with WTO. So there will be limited use of quota. However, government would be a little bit, you know, on the defensive side while using quota, unless there is very strong and compelling reason. So you can ask that only this much quantity should be imported, something like that. Imports can be restricted by DGFT. Suppose many of the electronic items have been stopped by saying national security and, you know, espionage and surveillance grounds. So similarly, imports can be restricted. But again, you have to provide a reason why that import should be restricted. Again, minimum import price. For example, in steel industry, there was that you cannot bring that good below that price. So again, it's a level of, you know, extra pricing, that because you cannot freely import, there has to be a minimum price, and usually that minimum price is said to be high, so it discourages import. So these are the things you should talk about. I know very frequently it's talked about that standards and regulations should be updated. While talking about it, I want to give you a rider that when you are going for standards, you should be careful that whatever standard BIS approves or employs, that will also be applicable for domestic supply. That means that you also need to comply with that standard. If you yourself cannot comply with that domestic standard, that standard if you impose, then you yourself will not be able to sell that product domestically. So while talking about standards, be assured that whatever standard you are proposing, you are also compliant about that standard. But again, it's a good way to restrict imports. So, and other thing is incentivize domestic industry. Like China, for example, incentivizes, it's frequently said that a lot of domestic industry. So we, for example, earlier COVID relief packages, and I will also talk in short about what DGFT offers for exporters. So we have to incentivize. So these are the ways you can use. But as I said, each comes with some negatives, each comes with some balances, and you have to think about it and present your case so that you can take benefit out of it. I would strongly suggest that look at these tools, which tool suits your industry better, talk among yourself, talk about export promotion councils, talk with MSME industry, because you all belong to MSME, and they should help you out in identifying which tool suits you better. And if you have a case, if you have a genuine case, certainly government as wants to reduce imports, it will certainly help you out. But as I said, nothing is free. You have to become competitive. any kind of major cannot be perpetual. As I said, infant industry, how long you want to remain infant? The protection cannot be perpetual. While the protection is giving for you to improve, you have to improve your competitiveness. And your competitiveness comes from quality. Your competitiveness comes from cost, minimum cost, or the better pricing. And your competitiveness comes from innovation. So suppose if you have got that anti-dumping duty, suppose you have got that raise in tariffs, you have to understand that that cannot go on perpetually. So you have to, in the meantime, while that protection is there for 5 years, for 10 years, for 6 years, whatever it may be, you have to work on your quality, you have to work on your cost minimization, and you have to work on your innovation so that your product is wanted in the market. Because at the end of the day, you try to understand, if somebody has to buy a phone, when he goes in the market, he cannot simply be driven by the nationalistic feeling. He has to consider the economic cost also engaged with it, right? So unless your mobile is better in quality, better in price, and more innovative, people will fall back to the product which gives them maximum utility, right? So while that protection is there, you have to use that time in quality maximization, cost minimization, and innovation. As I said, foreign trade policy also tries to, incentivize domestic sourcing. For example, those who are exporting, they must be knowing that if you are importing under EPCG scheme domestic capital goods, then your export obligation is reduced by 25%, which is a huge amount. Now coming to advance authorization, again, invalidation letter is issued for sourcing domestic product. But these are the policies when you want to import for exporting the product. So the whole goal is, we are trying to help out those consumer industry in the India who intends to export at the end. So these provisions are only available for who are going to export finally. These provisions are not available for a final consumer in India. Okay. And the last slide is that while making an import substitution strategy or coming in favor with you, government will think about these things. Government will think about WTO, whether it's WTO compatible or not. Because if it's not WTO compatible, other countries will take India to WTO. There was a domestic content requirement in solar cells, right? And India lost that case in WTO, and finally India had to withdraw. So the point is, while taking a decision in favor of you, government has to think about WTO. Hence, you have to be careful. You have to understand that everything given to you will be time bound. We are going to be labeled as protectionism. For example, right now, everybody criticizes US that they are protectionist. So India, who is supporting free trade so far, it would harm our image that also. And as I have already mentioned, the challenges of standards, that whatever standards will be employed, that will be applicable to even domestic sales. So unless you meet those standards will not help your cause. We need to have domestic capacity. It's not simply that we will switch off imports one day. There is a challenge that government should be assured that there is enough domestic capacity so that the supply chain would not be disturbed. And again, as I said, a lot of exports are dependent on imports. For example, petroleum products, diamond polishing. These are the exports which are dependent on import. We cannot live without them. So also import substitution will not happen in that cases. So if your product falls in that category, import substitution is not going to happen. And again, it cannot be permanent. Whatever protection you are being given for being infant industry, or whatever protection you are being given, that will have a sunset clause. That will have a sunset that will end at one point of time. So you have to be very careful that don't waste that time, right? For example, lockdown was being used to create health infrastructure. If you don't use that time properly, then at the end of the day, when that sunset will set in, then you will say that, oh, we didn't do anything, we still need protection. And at that point in time, WTO or some ruling will come which will not help you out. So use that protectionist time to build your capacity. And as I said, in the end, only thing which will help you out is becoming competitive. Unless you are competitive, consumer will look at their own satisfaction, consumer welfare, and consumer welfare will be dictated by quality, pricing, and the product. Okay? So it's not easy. I know that it's easy to whip up nationalistic feeling and try to ask everyone to follow it. But at the end of the day, when consumer puts their money, they will seek utility. Okay? So these are the things you need to look for. So think about your own industry. Think about which tool suits you better. Talk among yourself. Talk to export agencies. Talk to MSME department. Talk to DGFT officials. And try to find out which strategy works for you better. Okay, this was my presentation. Thank you. Thank you again for the opportunity. And this is my email ID, just in case if you need to contact me. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sir, for a very nice and elaborate presentation. Now I request Sri Kamal Sahu to present. Requesting Kamal Sahu, head of UNESCO, to give his presentation. Okay. So I request him to minimize the time limit. We have running out of time, so 15 minutes, Sri Kamal Sahu.
Is it visible to you, Mr. Naik?
Just it's uploading.
Okay.
Yes, okay. Yeah, continue.
Very good evening to all. And thank you very much for this opportunity to share my experience in CEO. Basically, this federation, I'm looking up to the Odisha chapter office, Federation of Indian Export Organization, set up by the Ministry of Commerce, Government of India. Basically, our work is to promote the export in the state of Odisha, to create new exporters in future. If they go for the export business, government can realize the foreign currency. This is the basic objective of FIO, not only in our state Odisha, but also in entire the pan India. So we're working on that. And as you know that Odisha recently Export Preparedness Index 2020, we are in the fifth position in India, basically second in export ecosystem, fourth among coastal states, and fifth in overall ranking. These are the things that, because I must congratulate all the stakeholders of Odisha, those have given their best of the best contribution to reach this goal. EPM, DPM, CO, and MPEDA, EIA, DGFT office was there at that time, but a couple of months back it was shifted to and merged with zonal office in Kolkata. And they all peoples are working to achieve this target. There are lots of opportunities, as you know, that recently government of our ministry, Mr. Piyush Goyal, has given that these are the sectors new startup exporters, they can focus. These are the areas, and I will explain after that which are the areas which can we can enter as a startups, in particularly for the Odisha. And this slides is basically belongs to Odisha state. As you know that 80 trillion market all over the world, and if you're talking about the international trade, there at the market of 20 trillion, near about 20 trillion world market, because import export market in the world, and more than 200 countries in the world. And India is exporting more than 300 billion, and as you know that 1 billion is equal to 7,500 crores. It depends upon the dollar rate. suppose your dollar rate is 70 rupees, 1 billion is equal to 7,000 rupees. And after COVID, as you know, that so many things has changed. Some countries have lose many things, but some countries has gained a lot. And India is one of them. India has a lots of challenges to grow their economy, to increase their export. There is lots of challenges for the economy. In these slides, you can imagine that what are the opportunities coming in future. If we're talking about the exports, we are exporting nearly 324 billions, and at the same time, we're importing 484 billions. There is a trade gap, means near about more than 100 billions is trade gap we have. And there is, if you manage with the trade gap, we have to, only options we have that, we have to go for the export business. There is no other options we have. We have to go for the export business. And export is such a business that without paying a single tax to the government of India, you can enjoy your foreign currency. There is no tax on export except few goods. Suppose you are exporting iron ore, you have to pay the tax. But value addition products, you don't have to pay any tax. And these are the figures that exporting. And these are some products. These are the future products which we can focus. Our startups can focus pharma, medical, surgical equipment, technical textiles, processed foods and agri products, welded products, industrial machineries, electronic, laptop, computers, office, biotechnology, IT, ITS, and animation, gaming. These are the products which our exporters can focus these areas. Everybody knows that the Prime Minister has told you can have a CADA for the COVID-19 regarding the CADA and all. And what happened that if you go for preparation of CADA, it's quite difficult part. If you have to boil the water, then you have to put the ginger and so many thing ingredients you have to put. But if you have a sachet type of products, if you go for a manufacturing of a sachet type products, like if you fly in the planes and you might have seen that the aerospace is coming with a, if you demand for a coffee, they are coming with a hot water and there is a sachet, pound sachet there, it's the ingredient of your sugar and coffee and your Amul. Everything is there, and so they just open it and they have steer it and they are serve it to you. And the same way also you can do that also, because if you manufacture such a type of things regarding the CADA, hot water, you can mix it. These are the things which can be a huge potential. It is a future demand of the world. Immunization booster, and as you know that. Honorable Minister Harshvardhan sir was the WTO chairman, and definitely though these people are in a bigger post in WHO, definitely their main intention will be to promote the Indian products. What are the Indian products regarding your Ayurvedic or your wellness products or Yunani, or these are your homeopathic and all, yoga and all, these are the, definitely they will be promote this type of products not only in our country but also in the entire world. These are the future products which we can focus in our Atmanirbhar Bharat. As you know, this is no doubt, this is in Oriya. These are the very people are using this water. So you know that well water is a very good water. Mineral water. If you compare with that, well water is better than the mineral water. And these are the things which from the photo itself, you can imagine the demand of the products in the near future. These are the products is available in our country. We never use these products. But world is looking for this type of products. Neem sticks and all. You have to pack it in a better. Nicely you have to pack and you can sell it in a better market. If you go for these are the products you can do that, and how can you market? I just show you in the next slides. These are the few products is a emulation booster products which can also focus for that also. And these are the, you know, herbal dietary supplements, and you know that food supplement has a good demand in the world, because all people say in the world they are looking for the food supplements. Because in India, what happened that we are always having rice and but in the foreign countries they have you know bar health bar supplementary foods and bar also, you know that food bars. These are the huge demand in the future markets. These are the future markets, and honey and what a tribal products. Lots of tribal products is available in our country, in our state also, in Odisha also. That we can also market. Wellness products has a good demand. You can see these products. Patanjali have taken a very excellent market, not only in our country but also in the world. People are looking, particularly for the Indian people, are looking for the Patanjali products. Other products, they are also, you know, Himalaya products, and these are the products really they are looking for. That there's a huge, tremendous opportunities here. Tremendous opportunities here to they can sell their new startup. People can start. They can do better marketing with this. And drumstick, as you know, that drumstick has lots of drumsticks. Lots of medicine values is there. It has a good dry drumsticks are exporting from our country to Dubai. All the Gulf countries, GCC countries, were exporting because most of the people are staying in Gulf countries from the south, and these people are staying and for the summer and all, they are putting these drumsticks and all dry drumsticks. It has a good market. Also, we can focus for these are the very these products are available in our state, in our country. We can go for this type of products. These are the, you know, tea has a good demand. And you know, green tea has a green tea after COVID. Green tea has a tremendous demand. Coffee has a tremendous demand in the world. In our country also, there are lots. You might have seen that hot tea, coffee, green tea, and blue tea. Something blue tea is also coming up. These are the immunization booster. These are the products we can do marketing in the world, because this is the right time that we can focus our product. We can search for a product we can market in the world. Also, IT has a tremendous demand. You know that AI technology, blockchain, data analytics. These are the areas which we can do that. Vietnam is a good market for that. And as you know that government of India has banned so many Chinese apps just a couple of days back, 138 video games they have banned. So these are the tremendous demand. Our IT developers, app developers, they can do that. You know that TikTok has gone, which our Uriya guy has created a Chingari or something like that. The apps has developed, and he is getting lots of traffic on that. And these are and Vietnam is our you know that Vietnam is a country. They don't you know that they have a lots of opportunities, or Japan, or these are the areas which can IT can have plays a vital role there. And as you know that slowly we have to facing the challenges from the Vietnam, Bangladesh, Cambodia. These are the countries that we have to face the challenges, because they were due to that FTA free trade agreement, they are giving lots of challenge to India. But India has to prepare. If we're talking about that Australia and Japan, Australia, these are the countries which lots of potential is there. You know, in Vietnam they have a population of 10 crores only. They have a population of 10 crores. In Australia they have a population of 2.5 crores, but they are challenging to the world, because we have a 130 crores population we have, but we are imagining that 100 crores people are we are not using their talent, and we are not using that 100 crores people's that their talents. But these are the big challenges for India in future. But we can focus, because everything is ease of doing it will be
you know, in a proper way. So people, new people should be coming, because I particularly have seen people are coming with lots of, you know, after in my office also people are coming after 1 year, 2 or 3 years, and they are moving. Even also few Uriya guys, they are staying in London and US. They want to come back to India. They come back to Orissa and they want to start something. But there are lots of problem. No government office is entertaining there. Even also they are not able to meet the officials and all. These are a very small challenges here. They are coming to us. I have to give the reference to them. They are going and they are speaking to them. They are a little bit okay on. Still, there are lots of challenges for that. For the hardware products also, these are the software hardware products, because India is importing lots of chips. And lots of chips, government of India is, our country is importing from the Taiwan and China. Yeah. But government of India is planning to manufacture this type of, small chips manufactured here, and no doubt we'll be use this, and we can also export these chips to the other parts of the world. And mass has a tremendous demand, as you know, that lots of mass is you are manufacturing here. Also, we can do exports. Lots of opportunities there. These are the things we can see also. No doubt, Sambalpuri is a very famous fabric over here. These are the things. These are the things which we can, from the Orissa, we can do exports. So these are the products. You know, in 95 price is 250-500 rupees, whereas one gamcha or is a price is 100 rupees or 70-80 rupees. So we can promote this khurda gamcha and this type of gamcha, so that we can get a good market. These are some products which we can do manufacturing and use that. These are the things from the, we are manufacturing from the bamboos. Okay. And you know that government of India is giving the budget of 1,200 crores, but they are just planting the year, but there is no machines. But we can get the same products is manufacturing in Vietnam. We can get them instead of importing these products to India. It's better that we can import the product in a zero duty, and we start manufacturing of these products, because the raw material, say bamboo, is available here. We can manufacturing, we'll cater to the domestic market, and the same time hum log bhi bahar export bhi kar sakte hain, bahar dusra countries ka hum log export kar, because it's a eco friendly products. Chota chota machine jo hota hai hum log ka india ka jo chinese ka machine hota hai, no doubt wo innovative hote hain, jisse bataya ki panigra sahab ne aur mr sahab ne bataya ki bahut innovative hote hain sab. Because why they are innovative, because their chinese government is giving lots of opportunities to the foreign investors. When the foreign people are coming to manufacture their products, they are coming with a resource model, their innovative products. No doubt they are innovator. They are coming with an innovative products, and they are start manufacturing, and China is copying to that, and they are exporting the same thing. But if you compare to the products of Chinese, these machines with the Chinese products, because our product has a, our small machines has a tremendous demand, because it's a commercial, it is viable. It's not a Chinese. After 3 months or 5 months, it will not go for any maintenance for that, because less maintenance products, and government and most of the countries are demanding for this type of products from India, and lots of innovation is required for that. And here there is a lot of opportunities. So there is opportunities, we can export small. We are already exporting. Just a couple of days back, one of our exporter, he is working with a company. Now this man is exporting welding machines to Germany. Just say already German welding machines to Germany. And these are the things is coming up. And technical textiles has a future demands, and normally garments we are using, but technical textiles has a tremendous demand, because it can be used for the these you know that firefighting or you know the flights also and for the yeah, and as you know that already told that PPE we never you know that we are not manufacturing of PPE kits but we are second largest exporting manufacturing of PPE kits. So every product has a every we have a talent, we have a infrastructure, we can go for that, we can challenge any challenges coming, we can where we people are ready to accept the challenges, but thing is that it should be in a proper way. And see these things they just imagine our Odia guy has got the patent for this product, this product, how can you sleep and all. This Odia guy has developed this product for the Boeing and Airbus. They have to develop the potential, we can go for that. Locally, as you know that so many things is available in locally, lots of things is available and we can focus for this product. What are the products is that, and GI has many people are coming to towards what are the products we can export. See, in Orissa we have a near about 20 GI products. We can focus with the GI product, we can do export the GI products in India. Near about 300 to 400 GI products in India, and another 400 to 500 application is pending there. Also, myself also involved with the filing of a GI for the Odisha Rasgulla and all, because I know the this product, the demand of these products, because these are the product, unique products which is not available in entire the world, because this is the particular place these products is available. We can do in a nicely, we can do it market and we can get a good revenue for our country. And these are the local products, you know, that papad and pickle. People, Ganesh is, they are exporting 700 crores of export of pickles. Just imagine, these are the local products. We have to pack it in a nicely, we have to do the in a better packaging, we can do that and we can sell it, this product. These are the very local product, you know, local vocal for local. And as your Prime Minister has already told that make in India, make for the world. But because India, the time has come that we don't have to sell for the our country, we have to manufacture it for the world. And the when you are thinking about the manufacturing for the world, means the quality and the packaging sort of should be in that that levels it should be maintained. Ragi and all these are the things, any doubts in that, they can come and they can spices a good demand, and you know, ginger, turmeric has a tremendous demand in the world, turmeric, because the immunization boosters. And if you go to the Italy, you'll find organic turmeric has a tremendous 50 gram of turmeric. It's a 300 to 400 rupees for 50 gram of turmeric. We have to go and we have to search for the market. These are the some products, and these are the some products which you can do value addition on these products. And seafood we are exporting, where the maximum exports from our state. And even around 3,000 crores we are exporting of seafoods from our state. And these are the some precious, semi-precious stones, precious also available. But thing is that we are just rough semi-precious stones we are sending, but we are not polishing it, because we don't have any policy. We are not polishing it. Otherwise, we are sending in a 100 rupees, but people are selling in a 1 lakh rupees. These are the difference between us. Handicraft products, we have a 50 crafts. You have a 50 crafts available in our state, but we are only 2-3 crafts we are exporting. And these are the things which we can. Handloom has a good demand. Handloom mark has come. Brand plays a vital role in the when you are exporting your products to the world. Sari has a good demand. You can see when the Prime Minister is coming, even British Prime Minister is coming to his first day and to office, he wear Indian saris. When the Prime Minister is coming to meet anyone, every Indian is that they love to wear saris. Sari, even also Russian people, Eastern devotees are, they love to have these saris. Lungi, as you know that good demand over there, it has a good demand, and it has a good demand because in all the countries, the Gulf countries, these are the thumbs things which we can go for the exports, and these are the these are the handloom products has a good demand. We can do that. And these are the some innovative products, because as you know that we are always thinking about the innovative products, and Government of India is focusing on that. Mrs. are also told about that. Panigrahi are also told about many things. So just imagine sari, but this is an innovative idea. Just imagine. And these are the things, the innovative ideas, how they just imagine the year and good demand it has. These are the way of marketing your products. Brand has a place, a vital role, and these are the, and if you go for a marketing your products, and these are the online marketing, everybody has seen that online marketing plays a vital role, and JioMart or you know that Google, Jio has you know that they come to got a very good tremendous demand on the online marketing. Amazon came, and recently Amazon opened their warehouse in Singapore. So because nobody knows many things, but we can you can send few stocks to the Singapore Amazon store, and we can sell the products in Indonesia also. Immediately you can you know that's you know open a store in Amazon or eBay, or you can go for that. Just imagine that prasad is available in online, and the same time also we are getting these cakes, pure cow dung cakes we are getting on Amazon. Just imagine, friends, we have a best of the best product is in our hand. We just think is that we have to open our eyes, and we have to market how we can do our market. Just imagine, friends, just imagine this chariot. Just the way they are doing the marketing, just simply a charpoy, but they are you know market in $9,990, $50,000. Just imagine, friends, these just everything will be sellable. Everything is sellable, but thing is that you have to open your eyes, and you have to market your products. These are thank you very much. Hope that everybody have a little bit knowledge about this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kamalo, for your nice presentation. Any questions, participants? If you have any question to any specific panelists?
Absolutely. Okay.
Any questions? We don't have any question.
Sir, Guru Mana sir said question. Guru Mana sir said question.
Kamala, please stop sharing presentation. Nobody has any question, so conclude the meeting. I'd like to thank Sri Anand Mishra, Deputy DGP Kolkata, Sri S.N. Panigrahi, corporate speaker, Konmal sir from so thank you all participants for concluding the meeting.
Nice,
Babu.
Hello.
Thank you. Sir, we are concluding, sir.
Can we take a group photo?
Yeah, Panigrahi sir.
Nayak Babu, small suggestion. Can we take a group photo with all the panelists?
Yeah.
Everybody take the video, then it will be visible. We can take the photo.
Anand Mohan Mishra has left the meeting.
Okay.
Anand Mohan Mishra has left the meeting.
And others, everybody is there.
Please,
Kamalji.
Please unmute your video. Samasthe apna mera video ta unmute karantu. We'll take a photo.
Yeah, yeah.
Samasthe apna mera video unmute karantu. Thank you very much. Yeah, concluding the meeting. Thank you all.
Call, call, call.